Jesus.
Oh, hi, I'm Jack.
Hi, I'm Naomi.
Hi, I'm Ruby.
Oh, what's up? I'm Shay.
And we're the head boys and girls team.
Ofsted said we were good.
We say we're average.
Mr. Fell says we've got better maths results than Shanghai.
Why don't you come and have a look?
Hi, welcome to our science department. We're a specialist science college and have alumni such as Steve Hawking. Please come and have a look in one of our classrooms.
Science
show.
All right, okay, cool. Sorry.
Blood for blood.
What am I saying?
Same thing.
Blood for blood.
It was the afternoon of May 24th, 2018. An innocent teacher was found dead in her classroom. But the door was locked from the inside. Only a strand of hair, a second strand of hair, and a footprint would lead investigators to the truth.
Harlington School of Witchcraft and Wizardry has been known to have trouble in the past.
Oi, Samus, you got off with Cameron on Saturday night. I heard at Jake's party.
So what? Maybe if you weren't so bloody frigid and gave me what you wanted.
Oh yeah, like I'm a slag. Oh.
But not like this. Nothing like this.
I knew from the get-go that Potter idiot would get involved. Once I spilled Ribena on my classroom floor, he was convinced it was blood. The backlash was incredible.
Snape, come on!
There he is!
Get him!
Harry Potter was known throughout the school for his kindness and bravery.
Opiamus!
He'd been trying to see Snape fired for years. Could his methods have become more sinister?
Mr. Potter, what do you say to the claims that you murdered McGonagall with the intention, with framing Snape? Mr. Potter!
You ever stop to think that, you know, Snape did murder her? Get a camera out of my face!
It was about this time that we found the strands of hair. It had reached boiling point at school. Everyone was a suspect.
Tell us the truth!
You should have been fired a long time ago, Mr. Sides.
That strand of hair. It was a real breakthrough in the case.
Boss, we found something.
On their way to formulating a case, the investigative team thought it best they call upon renowned forensic scientist Minerva she's dead. Draco Malfoy to review the case.
I knew before doing anything else that beautiful, unknowable, tempestuous Harry Potter had done this. Couldn't have been anybody else. That's why they don't call me a criminal profiler for nothing.
It's forensic scientist.
Who?
You can always do the fan like this.
I think the number one suspect is Mr. Craze.
Do you mean Harry Potter?
No, Mr. Craze. Have you seen this, Hermione?
Have you seen Detective Voldemort?
Don't bother. It's him.
It was this that truly turned Harlington upside down. To discover that Voldemort, a man so instrumental, so loved in their community, would commit such a crime. It was unfathomable. After that night, he was never seen again. To this day, some still believe they saw him in a crowd, heard him in a song, felt his presence in a science lab. But it truly seemed as though he was gone forever. On the bright side, however, they found Harry Potter.
The only place where you can get a GCSE qualification and salmonella.
Welcome to the Great British Bake Off! Bakers, you have 4 hours. On your marks, get set, bake!
Yeah, I'm feeling really confident. I've been practicing those for this, so I really think, I've got this one in the back.
I've been awake all night practicing this. I'm pretty sure I could do it from my eyes closed, but we'll see. I don't want to get too confident or anything.
It's a really difficult bake. I've never baked anything like this before.
Me and Paul are looking for one bowl of cereal. Not too dry, but not too soggy.
This challenge is really a test of the baker's versatility and precision. The cereal should be well moistened, but not too soggy. If it's too soggy, it loses its taste, its texture.
The bakers need to put the right amount of milk in at the right amount of time. Too much, it becomes a drink. Too little, it loses what makes it cereal.
How are we doing?
At the moment I'm right on track. I'm just washing the bowl and then I'll pour the cereal in.
And how are you going to tackle that?
I think I'm just going to...
Edge,
just take it slow, yeah.
When Emma Watson isn't baking, she loves to steal school supplies and sit in silent contemplation of everything she's done wrong in life.
Things have been quite rough after Harry Potter, but, you know, if my name isn't Emma Watson, then I'm going to win this bake-off.
Watson will be working with Cocoa Pops today, layered with milk and sprinkled once more with cereal.
It's a difficult challenge, this one, but I'm sure you can tackle it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Hi, Jeffrey. Everything okay?
Yeah.
Have you practiced for this at all?
Yeah, loads!
Loads?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Spends his free time volunteering at a local library and teaching dogs how to read.
Reese's cereal is made up of cornflakes and, of course, milk. It's not at all boring, though. Reese has promised that a special twist of vodka added to the milk will spice up the cereal and bring him the win.
Are you edging in the cereal?
I thought it'd be best to tip it all in, you know, like ripping off a plaster.
Are you sure that's the best idea?
I'm gonna give it a go.
Okay.
Well, I didn't have much of a leg to stand on, so...
But it works for me, so.
Aunt, is he putting the milk in first?
Nice.
It's a valiant effort, but you can see that the milk is actually swallowing the cereal.
It's awful.
Now, Reese, we're promised a special edition.
Whenever you're ready.
Being in the... First week of this school, I've heard really good things, and I'm really excited to start.
Mr. Horton has just finished his master's degree and is excited to inspire the sixth form students to follow a career into maths. However, he is worried about how his message will be received by the teenagers.
No one's a particular fan of maths, but I'm really hoping to change a few students' minds.
Unfortunately for Mr. Horton, he still hasn't realised that no one has turned up to his first lesson.
Okay, so this time, instead of having a zero, we have got a time dependency to it. So
2 very boring minutes later.
Ultimately, it's still just a second order differential equation, exactly the same as last time, but I've got 2 parameters that I'm trying to keep track of. Any questions? Oh, for f***ing sake.
All around me are familiar faces, worn out places.
It's been a tough first week for Mr. Horton, but he's determined to stay positive.
Being new in a school always comes with some stick, but it is part of the job. However, all of the teachers here have been really welcoming and very helpful.
Wrong room, sorry.
Mr. Horton is late for class after being stuck at the traffic lights coming from Barton for over an hour.
Oh dear, looks like the new teacher's got the wrong room.
Furniture, broken chairs, litter on the floor.
Noise is incredible. Throwing food, bottle flipping, yeah. Not wearing their lanyards.
Thanks.
Welcome to the English department. English, much fun. Many good. Lots
love. Oh, I am fortune's fool. Where is my love? I must speak to her at once, or else all hope is lost.
Romeo! Romeo! All hope isn't lost! I'm over here!
Oh, what is it, my love? A freedom of freeze? A light in the darkness over my impending A-levels?
Oh, be bloody realistic.
I can't quite make it out. It's too far away. Wait, through the ether. It's becoming clearer to me.
Watch the breakdown.
I'm so excited to be back in the director's chair here at Harlington after a very brief hiatus. I can't go too much into the specifics right now, but let's just say I've done a little bit of acting in a little Broadway play that I'm sure will be a huge hit.
Gina was cast as Fiona during the production of Shrek the Musical. Legend has it
that her singing was so bad, a woman went into cardiac arrest during that I'm a Believer number. It didn't last very long though. Jeannie spent a brief period of time in a juvenile detention centre. This was for rugby tackling Andrew Lloyd Webber outside the Barbican tube station.
This is my office, we've got some folders, planes, Steinbeck.
But Jeannie is undeniably talented. She's done so many transcendent school plays. These include
Cats, Dogs, Cats 2, Baby Got Cat, Return of Penis Boy, The Venom of Denim, 20 Piece Short of an Ice Bun.
And of course the seminal masterpiece.
Does That Make Me Crazy?
Where, yeah, she sung Gnarls Barkley Crazy. It was wonderful.
Right, so here's my space. Shrine to Shakespeare here. Classic Shakespeare, that. Would you know I met him once? Down the pub.
Shakespeare's been dead for hundreds of years.
You've all missed me. I'd have missed me too. But this time I'm back for good. The Andrew Lloyd Webber lawsuit permitting. We're doing Hunger Games, the musical. And it's gonna be just like my bar mitzvah. Ultra violent and filled with greasy teens. So everybody get up, get your acting caps on, as Daniel Radcliffe once said to me. Get out of my house! My neck, my back, lick my and my crack.
But I don't know what to do.
I'm head girl, and that's all I have.
J'ai décidé à présenter le fabuleux destin d'Amélie Poulain.
This is part song of my new album. Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool?
Alright everybody, you've all got roles. I've cast you all except for Sophia, who's going to be playing the cannon that goes off when people die. What? How? You need to stop acting like a and more like a cannon, okay?
Bitch.
For me, rehearsal is the most important part of the process.
Your mind is a balloon.
French bitch, go! Oh. You're a cat. This church is made out of water. But you know what worms really love? It's really about breaking down the boundaries. You're a bee!
I'm a bee!
What are you?
I'm nothing but a bee!
You're a bee!
I'm a bee!
Someone call her a bee!
I'm a bee!
Everyone call her a bee!
I'm a bee!
I'm a bee!
You're 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 a bee!
About finding your inner performer, but also your inner being.
I heard she was something else. She is something else.
Unlike anything I've ever experienced before.
She's like the Beast of the East of drama teachers.
She definitely needs to be sectioned.
It's like a dream where you're standing on the edge of a cliff and your childhood bully is there.
Oh, she's f***ing crazy. Stop! It's time for rehearsals. I'm really trying something new here. I mean, are we trying to replicate the film shot for shot?
Primrose Everdeen.
I volunteer! I volunteer as tribute.
Yes, we are, but we're also trying something new.
Go, Tina! Go, Tina! Go, Gail! Oh. Come on!
Tackle!
Oh, no!
I've asked some investors to come down and talk to Jeannie about financing some of the more high-concept parts of the play.
They have absolutely no idea what they're doing.
It's a complete mess. I mean, I teach Ed Ayres and Bellinardi, and even they can do better than that.
Well, I wouldn't go that far, but it is an absolute insult to the craft of school plays.
It's a complete f***ing disaster.
You know, everyone's against me right now, but I really think it's going to be incredible. This is going to be the Citizen Kane of Amdram school play YA film adaptations. It's going to be great. Rehearsals have been challenging.
How's rehearsals going?
Have you seen Shrek 4 Happily Ever After? Kinda like that.
She slammed my head into a locker and said, if I told anyone, she would kill everyone I love.
My dad worked for MI5 and even he's afraid to be in the same room as her.
The whole time she's been calling me Dan, she keeps asking me for money.
She called me fat 22 times a day.
You're fat!
23.
I'm gonna kill you, Katniss. If we die, we die together.
Yeah! What the fuck was that? Huh?
You can't talk to me like that!
Oh, if Mr. Golden can, then so can I.
Then I'm gonna report you.
Oh, they're not gonna report me, honey. Not after I found out that Mr. Craze was the Zodiac. Get out of here!
What?
Get out!
No, wait! No!
I'm honestly convinced these idiots have no acting ability. I've seen better acting in a Suzuki car commercial in the ad break of Anton Deck's Saturday Night Takeaway, and that is saying something.
No, don't die! No.
Babe!
No!
That was Is this what I left Rada for? For you guys? For this? Is it?
Is it?
I could have been on Holby City. Maybe even call the midwife if I was lucky. Fuck a lot of you!
Well, she seems upset.
Welcome to Hole in the Wall. We've got people, we've got holes. People are going to go through those holes and you're going to watch. Contestant number one.
What am I doing here? Why am I here?
Contestant number one.
I actually just came to get my phone charger and then I saw the production team and they asked me to sign a contract that I need to do anything that goes inside on the room or something. I don't really understand what's happening.
Great. So, what are you wearing? Who are you wearing?
Oh God, what's happened to me? What have you done?
I don't know.
Have you drugged me or something? Where am I?
How Vogue. So, let's see you dance. Dance. Contestant number two. Now I've got a better look at him, I'm thinking contestant number one.
Oh,
my god. Thank you so much for having me. Big time fan of the show. I've wanted to come and win ever since I found out that I get to pour molten hot cheese on the people I love.
Yeah, you don't get to do that. Repeat, you do not. You don't get to do that. Don't listen to him.
I'm not ready yet.
Wow. Disgraceful. Awful. Shit. Contestant number two, you're the winner. I hope that's filled the hole in your heart.
I'm the winner.
Oh dear. Oh dear. That's a sad.
I'm the winner! I'm the winner! You're the hole and I'm the wall, bitch!
Bogies. Bogies.
Bogies. Bogies.